There we go.
I think we're good.
Am I recording? I don't know.
You might be. I hope you are because I
I
am.
don't know. This meeting is being, it says it's being recorded.
Oh, then you're good. You're good.
Hold on.
Been a couple months
Okay,
since.
yeah, I'm recording. Hey, look at
It's been a couple months, guys. It's been like 2 months, I think, since we've done a
that.
podcast.
Clearly, and I'm borderline retarded, so
We have to start from
I think you're good.
scratch.
All
And
right. I don't know.
we've had some
Everything,
technical issues on
everything's
someone's
a
end.
everything's a problem. I hate computers. I'm gonna put out a mag. I'm gonna do this by magazine, I think. We're just gonna fucking release a magazine and be done with it.
I
Clearly,
think
we're
so.
not. Clearly, we're not capable of computer work.
I mean, I've been ready for about 45 minutes, but
Shut up.
it's all right.
All right, well, that's it for today, guys. Thanks for joining us.
What's going on, everyone? Letting
Wait.
everyone know that we went and saw on the Sunday, we saw oh, today, we saw Ghostbusters. I mean, I don't know about your point of view, but I thought the movie could have been way better. The ending was the only thing I was actually looking for, and I thought it was going to start earlier in the movie with like the final boss, or you know what I mean? Just that scene that you're looking for. I
Yeah.
mean, we had a whole like another storyline. I'm like, I do not want to hear about this lady or this girl.
Yeah, I don't know. I liked it. It was good for what it was. The
The
first
first.
the original the other one the last one I guess was I think it
Way
was a bit
better.
better, but
Yeah. I couldn't. I almost wanted to walk out and just say, hey, I'm going to the bathroom and just never came back.
pulling in when you go to the bar. Yeah, I gotta go to the bathroom. I'll be back
Yeah,
and just
I'm
never come
back.
back.
Yeah, dude, it was one of those moments. I'm like,
The
no.
ending was pretty cool.
The ending was fucking awesome. It's just everything that led up to the ending was fucking shit. I'm like, oh,
It
come
took a
on,
minute.
dude.
I don't know. It was kind of felt like there was a story and a story kind of going on.
That's exactly how I felt. I'm like, they could have just stuck with one thing, but they kept jumping to like the main character girl. I don't think she should have been the main character because it didn't really help any of the story. It just, I mean, cool part. It did in one part when she, you know, went into a ghost form. And, but
Yeah, that was kind of cool how they did that.
I like that if they did that in like the first 12 minutes. But just saying.
You can't have the whole movie in 12 minutes. That's not how this works.
I mean, get better writers. It could have happened.
Should have called me. I'd have walked him through it.
But I gotta say, it's an okay movie. I just never would watch it again in my life. But the first one was better that they made. Like
Oh man.
that one was so good. It kept
It
me.
was, did you see the one with all the girls in it? It was way better than that.
Well, I've never seen that one. I'd never give it the chance.
You shouldn't.
So, yeah, well, I'll never watch that one because
You
I heard it
shouldn't.
was really bad.
I mean, it was, I don't know. It was all right for what it was. It wasn't a Ghostbusters movie.
Yeah, I think it was more of like a hey, women can be superheroes, nothing against them, but I'm just saying I think they did it like for like that kind of push. Even though it might be a really good movie, I know what kind of Ghostbusters movie I want to see.
Or
So it's like
a
a
Ghostbuster. Yeah, that's not that.
no, yeah, and I heard that from a lot of people, so I was like, I'll take everyone's word for it on this one.
Chris Hemsworth was pretty funny in it.
I didn't even know he was in that movie.
He's like the secretary that comes in to like after
Of
they
course he
form the
is.
Ghostbusters, and he's like a dumbass the whole time. He's like terribly stupid.
Just like a blonde person, like
Yeah,
just
yeah.
dumb.
But it's like to the extreme. It's pretty funny the way they made him look like a retard, but it was
Well, the thing is, I might like that humor, so like maybe I'll give it a chance one day. Just not any time in the next 1,000 years. I'm
that
just
part
joking.
is that part of the movie was pretty good, but the whole overarching
See, I know
plot
nothing
of the
about it.
movie,
I
and it
don't
was
even think I saw a trailer to it. That's because it wasn't really pushed in a way. Maybe it was, it just wasn't on like my algorithm of things I liked.
no, it was terrible. It was a terrible movie.
I think the only thing I would like out of that movie is like Melissa McCarthy was in it, which I like her as
She's
an
pretty
actress.
funny, and the other girl, they're all funny on their own, like as a comedian, as in other movies. Like Melissa McCarthy and Bridesmaid was fucking hysterical. That
I think
movie
that
was
was probably one of the best movies she's ever done or even played in as in like an act lead role actress. I think
that and
that
the
was.
Heat with Sandra Bullock. Oh, dude, that movie is fucking funny.
Actually think I did see that movie. I don't remember it though. It's a long time ago.
My daughter watched that movie over and over and over again. It was so funny.
Heat.
Where she's a cop with Sandra Bullock, but like detectives or whatever.
Oh, you know, I haven't seen that movie. I've seen bits and pieces of that movie, but man, what a Sunday afternoon. I wish I could just take it all back from the morning.
We should have just went golfing and called it.
Yeah.
That way we could have ruined our day golfing instead of going to a movie.
I'm glad I saw it, because of if there's another one, then I'll understand what's happening.
You won't only go because, see that one because of this one.
It's so true. No, I'll see it. I've always been a Ghostbusters fan, so I'll definitely see it.
At least I kept it in with the Ghostbusters.
And that's why I didn't hate the movie. It's because of they did, like, I just wish they would have wrote it a little differently. Like, I know that I can't be the only one that thinks that. I mean, I'm swear I was falling asleep in that movie. I'm like, and I saw you. You're yawning, fucking trying to keep yourself awake.
The marshmallow guys were funny. That shit was funny.
That made my like the first 45 minutes of the movie. I'm like, I like this movie just because of them.
Yeah, there was like 50 of them.
Yeah, dude.
They were like, they acted like the minions. You know what I mean? Like they were like hurting each other and like.
That's exactly how I looked at it. Like, yeah, that's exactly, it's minions. It was funny when the guy took the cigarette lighter and put it in his face.
Yeah.
And then he took it out and he's like smiling. Yeah.
Hilarious. And you can see the imprint of the burn.
Yep.
The circles.
those guys are hilarious. So like, I'll give them that. Like
that was really funny.
Fucking awesome.
But we're going to do AI today.
On other news. Oh, I was just going to say on other news. I mean, talk about everything that I now see on TikTok or like social media is pointing towards how advanced AI is getting. So we can switch subject now.
There was a reporter for the Rolling Stones back in like 2010, I think.
Yeah.
Michael Hastings was his name. He went to Afghanistan and was embedded with a troop of soldiers or whatever for, I don't know, X amount of time.
Yeah.
And he was with, and the leader, the, he was with a high ranking general, a really popular high ranking general. And after that, he was going to leave, but then they had the volcanoes in Iceland.
But is this recent?
Like 2000. Like 2010, okay. I think the story was.
Okay.
Was when this happened, anyway. There was a volcano somewhere, and they weren't able to fly, so they grounded all the aircraft. And so sure. He had to stay longer than he had originally intended. And, like, kind of off the record, on the record type deal, they caught the general talking shit about Obama, like, in a pretty major way. So that all, the whole thing went down. He got to come home, whatever. Well, they released the story. He wrote a story about it.
Yeah.
About this general. And the general had to resign or basically retire.
No shit.
You know, so anyway, the point of the story is the guy's name was Michael Hastings, and he was driving down La Brea at like 120 miles an hour in his car. And he hits a tree and the tree explodes, or the car just explodes.
The journalist did, or the
a couple of years later, like 2013, I think.
Oh shit, dude.
So obviously, you know, people are crying conspiracy, right? So
of course.
And another reporter was kind of following the story, and they were talking to someone about like car manufacturers. It was a car manufacturer or something. And they were talking about, you know, how is it possible that someone could
control
his car or, you know, whatever. And the guy was basically like, listen, if the thing's got a computer in it, we can get into it and we can make it do whatever we want.
And it doesn't matter what anyone says. If there is a computer chip in it, it can be hacked. It doesn't matter.
Right.
Like, so was he driving a Tesla or like a Rivian?
I don't know what kind of car it was, but the theory is that this guy was taken out because he was messing with a high-ranking beloved general, you know what I mean? And like, it was kind of a big deal. The guy had to retire, and like, you know, it's not far-fetched to think like this guy could like easily have a meeting and talk to one of his soldiers who loved him. You know, these guys are trained to kill and trained to do all kinds of things. It's not far-fetched to think that like, hey, maybe I need you to make this guy go away, you know what I mean?
I completely agree that they could control the car, dude. I think that's like, It's not talking shit about government. It's not talking about, I think that eventually that they're just going to control that.
I think we're probably 50 to 100 years away from just nobody driving. Like the cars are just going to drive themselves.
I think 15 years, dude.
I don't
20
know. Well,
years, 20
I don't know
years.
if you're going to
That's a
be able to
long
get
time.
rid of the cars that people have now. You know what I mean?
Unless there's a program where you can get it for free and they can control it. They
Maybe.
want, just like the government will, they're like, oh, you want this, this, and this from us. You just have to obey our rules and
Well,
we're going to give you this.
that's the problem. Like, you always have people who have strife in life, right? Like, they're having a hard
Yeah.
time, whatever. And some people are going to live their entire lives that way. And anything that the government does, they're like, oh, great. You know, you're doing something for me. They want more government in their lives. So anytime you
Yeah.
have that, you're always going to have people that are willing to give up a little bit. You know what I mean? And
Not
then,
even just a little bit, like their whole fucking freedom
yeah, well,
just to have
that's what it
free.
turns into is
Yeah.
eventually they just basically trying to control everything. Like, that's the theory behind it. You know
I
what I
think
mean?
that's what's gonna happen. I
If
think
you
that's a.
can control a little bit, you can then control a lot, you know?
Yeah, and I've heard it like multiple times. It's just that the more that you give up your freedom, the more freedom you're gonna get in a way. It's not in a bad way. It's just
That's
that's like,
the general idea. Like, that's what they believe. Like,
yeah,
I'll give
less.
up this, and this, and you're going to give me a universal basic income. You're going to, you know,
You're gonna have a
provide
RFID
me with
chip.
a, yeah, you're going to provide me with a place to live. You're going to provide me with food. I'm not going to have to worry about any of those things. And in
I
return, I'm going to
do
give me,
everything.
I'm going to let you give me a social credit score. I'm going to let you give me, you know,
I think,
take away cash out of the system. I'm gonna let you know what I mean? Like, I'm
and
gonna let you control everything else, but I just want to know I have food and shelter, and that's basically how they
I
think.
think they're gonna transition that way because of, like, if you've seen recently, and I know we all have, the AI robots that are so advanced now
It's
that
insane.
they are going to take our jobs. Like it's not even like a, oh, they can only take some. No, they can pretty much do fucking whatever they
So
want.
I was looking back at like the beginning of AI, and they've been messing with this since like the 50s.
Yeah,
There
dude.
was a guy named Alan Turing actually coined the phrase AI when he wrote a I don't know if it was a book or he published something. It was called Computer Machinery and Intelligence. And it
Yeah.
was basically, it proposed a test of machine intelligence called the imitation game. And this guy, you know, he was kind of the
This is when
father
they're
of.
first starting out.
Yeah. And then in like 91, the government kind of got involved and they had a program called Dynamic Analyst and Replanaging Tool. It's called DART. And it
Yeah.
basically was used to help move transport supplies, move personnel, logistics, all that stuff.
Yeah.
And it saved like millions of dollars for the military because nobody had to do it. Like, the AI just did everything.
I can see that where it progresses from there.
Yeah, so, you know, and this is in its infancy. This is in the 90s, you know, and I guess it was able to, like, you know, look at different travel patterns, different shipping patterns and stuff like that and say, okay, it's easier and cheaper if we ship it here, or easier and faster if we ship it there. And they
Yeah.
figured all this out, and the computer did all the work. So
It's just
it
problem solving.
that yeah, I mean, and it's just getting smarter and smarter and smarter.
It went from problem solving to art like artificial intelligence.
Yeah, because
That's the problem.
the first example of working AI was like written in like 1951.
Yeah.
And they basically started using it to play checkers. They taught it how to play checkers and it would play checkers against people.
Well enough to beat us.
Yeah, and you know, it
Like
learned and it would lose at first, but then as it learned, you know, it would start learning, and then it became very good at checkers. And now I play chess, and now it does, you know, all the things that it does. Like the video you were talking about, where the guy was like, you know, the robot had, and I think they were, it's OpenAI was working with BMW,
Yeah.
and they created this robot, an AI system. And there was a guy, a human on the other side of a table, and the robot was standing there with an apple and on a tray with some dishes. And the human was like, give me, provide me with something to eat. And the
Yeah.
guy picked up, and the robot picked up the apple and
And
handed it to him.
explained it to him why he did it.
Yeah, he's like, "Why did you do that?" He goes, "It's the only thing that was suitable as food, and it could differentiate between everything else that was there." And then it put the dishes away. And then as he was asking, "Why did you give me an apple as the food?" It was sorting trash and throwing trash away into a receptacle.
So thinking about multiple things at split second, you know what I mean? It's
Yeah.
thinking about four different things it just
It's
did
just
and explained it.
processing everything, you know what I mean, at
Yeah.
one time.
Yeah.
And the only real next step would be like quantum computing. And
Yeah.
that's like
Which they've
the
already done. Like they've had that, like a quantum computer.
Yeah,
Google has it.
and they just used the principle of quantum mechanics to process information, which obviously allows them to do tasks exponentially faster than any other computer. And that's how it's going to go. And
I
eventually we'll
heard,
be Skynet.
well,
And we'll have to
it's
destroy
not
people.
far off from that because of they can't control it till they can't control it. You know what I mean? It's just like it's unplugging the internet. You know what I mean?
Well,
That
they
have.
had those two robots. I forget what company. I don't know if it was ChatGPT or who, but they had the two robots that were started talking to each other. They started communicating
Without anyone.
in a language that no one understood, and they didn't know
Yeah.
why they were doing it. Now, it
Yeah.
might have been just a malfunction or whatever, and it didn't make any
Oh
sense to
shit.
anybody. Or these two fucking robots are communicating with each other, and
Yeah.
so they shut them down. They're like, "Well, we can't have that." So obviously, they shut them down because you'd be an idiot not to.
Yeah. But you don't know what they were saying because no one knows what they were saying. You know what I mean? It's just like a they have their own code
Yeah.
that they can communicate that they probably understand that we can't communicate with. So it's like
Well,
a
so I was thinking about this, right? Like, how far advanced can they be past human thought? Because a human programs them, right? Like, a human has to program, obviously, a very smart human.
But
So, can they interpret and learn past the ability to interpret and learn? Like, can they teach
I think
themselves that
so.
they need to learn more stuff, or are they just focused on learning?
I think they're programmed that way to do that. So they'll adapt very quickly.
Right.
So they're gonna remember everything that was already said, and they're gonna adapt off of that. So it's like
Right.
a quick process for them that I don't think that people
Well,
understand.
and then you have the question of like they get a lot of information from the internet. Well, how do you know what's true on the internet? And then how do you know what to censor, what not to censor? You know what I mean? Like
Oh
if
yeah, dude.
you're a far left wing guy and you take a far right wing guy, they're gonna have two very different ideas about 90% of the things in the world.
Yeah.
So which way is that computer gonna lean? Is it going to
I
lean
know.
toward the best of for everybody? Is it going to lean towards, the left wing guy
I don't
programmed me? So
I
I
think it's
have
only
left.
the person programming it and
Yeah,
what
so I
side they're
have
on.
left wing ideas, if you will, or right wing ideas. How does it differentiate that? How does it know? And then what about like false information? Does it know it's false information? Does it using, There's some really smart sounding people that are really dumb online. You
Or
know what I
they
mean?
just, or the thing is, they want to create chaos, and that's just, there's some people that want
Yeah,
that.
and
They,
can you prevent that? Can you prevent an AI from being fooled to the point to where
I,
it's not going to do something crazy?
and that's the problem. Like, would they would have to know everything to know that they're being fooled. You know what I mean? So are they already programmed with everything, or the like what you said, are they programmed one way, not the other,
Right.
and not being biased, as in they're not seeing both sides. They're only
Yeah,
seeing
because
one.
that's the problem. Like, human beings are naturally biased one way or another. Whether you
Yeah.
try not to be or not, your ideas and your thoughts, they interact with everything that you do. Everything you do is based somehow in like, your political thought or your whatever you're thinking about.
Yeah.
So how do you program that out to where they're just straight down the center, best for everybody, best for human beings.
I don't think there ever will be, because I think someone's gonna eventually just program it to be one way, and but
Yeah.
isn't threatening or passive,
And
like.
then what happens when you have one left ringing ro leaning robot and one right leaning robot.
Yeah,
you have a you have a MAGA robot and a Joe Biden supporting robot, and then they just kill each other.
And that's the thing, like, can they calculate what's the better choice, even though it's the wrong choice or the best choice? It doesn't matter. Like, they have to think about every little step.
Right,
they can't skip it. So,
and you know, the jobs argument is obviously a legitimate argument, but I look at it this way, right? Like, you know, 100 years ago, people built horse and buggy. They built buggies, right? Like, there were people that were building buggies. Well, obviously, the car replaced those buggies. Those people had to go do something else.
Yeah.
And it's the same thing with, like, the internet. All new technology is going to replace something. So always. you either got to have the jobs to replace those lost jobs, something else for me to do if you take my job, or you're going to have a universal income to where.
And I think that's going to go that way. Like,
or you have no monetary system. Like, everything is just provided for you from the government. Everybody has the same thing.
They have an allowance,
you know? Yeah.
Like, from where your social standing is and your, what you had as a job, that's going to be replaced. Like,
right.
I could eventually see, and it's not like a far-fetched thing. We're so advanced that the president would probably be a fucking AI, because it'd be the first in history. It, you know what I mean? They can calculate certain things. That also can be a downfall very quickly, but I could see it happening.
Well, like, you have some robot spaz out and hit the button.
not even for presidents, just for CEOs as companies to see and calculate every step. It's going to know exactly how to do it. And it's, I think it will start with business owners. They're just going to fucking have an AI do it. I think that's.
And I was thinking about that too. Like, AI can write you anything. AI can.
Yeah.
I've messed around with AI writing, like, opening statements and opening comments and whatever.
Same here.
Right. So my question is, who owns that? Do you own it? You didn't write it.
No.
An AI wrote it.
And that's the, I think that's one of the,
AI can't really own anything, but maybe the people that own the AI own it. You know what I mean? Like, how do you?
Is it the plagiarizers, or, you know what I mean? It's like, the, like, you can't.
Is it plagiarism? You know what I mean? Like,
and the thing is, like, how are they going to have a net code have a trail of that? I don't, like, they eventually there will be, like, there will be something in there, but, like, how can you even find that? That's, like, the problem.
You know, there's already people writing, like, college papers and theses and stuff.
Books, anything, any books, fucking. Yeah.
So,
I mean, anything you could think of.
How do you regulate that? Like, I can just tell my AI, I want you to write me a story about this. Go to bed, wake up in the morning, and it's done.
It won't even be done in that time. It'll be done within seconds.
Right, and then so what do you do? Like, so what, when I, you know what I mean?
When I mess with book? Like, yeah, can when I mess with. It? Unity. I mess with Unity 3D. It's like a software that you can create games and, like, VR games. And I went into ChatGTP and I was like, hey, write me a video game in Python on this. And I gave it an explanation. It gave me the entire coding of Python to throw into my software to make it the game. That's how good it is. Took
did it
seconds.
Did it make a game?
Oh, it made a game. Yeah,
like a playable seconds. Game. Like, what's
not playable, but the fundamentals of it,
right?
Where I would have to add certain things, but it gave me the storyline, it gave me the coding, it gave me everything to that point where I would have to work off of that. But it was like pages of Python coding.
That's crazy.
Within seconds, like, I did it in seconds, and I just copied and pasted and threw it over to see if it actually worked. Because, I mean, it will. I mean,
so let's say you make that game. Who owns that game?
That's the thing. Like,
is that your game? You came up with the idea, but you didn't write it.
And I think that's where there has to be, like, a fine line. If you're going to give us that reach, we own that reach if we ask for it. It's not a... I think that's how it has to go, because of who thought of that question to get to that point.
Right.
It was you. So, yes, the work's being done by algorithms and all that, but, like, you're the one that thought of that idea.
Yeah.
So that should have been... plain and simple.
Well, that's
idea.
The way I would think about it. I mean, it was my idea or whatever, but, you know, say you write a book and it you know, sells 100 million copies and you become super rich.
And you get sued off of ChatGPT.
Yeah, and the people from ChatGPT are like, well, you use my computer to do it. Like,
there has
I want
to be
half,
like a...
or I want, you know, whatever. Like,
and maybe that's what it will come down to down in the future.
Like, I don't know. That's...
how they're funding. Like, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Could be a percentage issue at that point. Like, okay, ChatGPT wrote this. We're going to take, you know, 60%, you're getting 40.
Right. Yeah. Like, yeah. Like, what's the number? What's the
and
split,
how,
you know?
Yeah. And that's where I think it'd be really weird situation. And the thing is, I think before that point, there'll be a, like, not a rebellion to it, but there's going to be something where people are not going to like the switch. Me personally, I don't think I'd be against the switch of AI, but the thing is, there has to be rules in place. Like, it's a, it we can't stop it. That's the problem.
See, like if you're working on a car, right?
Yeah.
And, you know, you're doing a brake, so you're doing a heavy job, like an engine or something, like a head gasket or something, right?
Yeah.
You could probably get a robot to do that. But then, you know,
I think there'd have to be a robot
know.
To do that in the, I don't think it could be a walking robot. I think it has to be where it's pulled into a certain spot, into a certain specification, and it's there, and then it knows exactly each bolt where to go.
But
so
what happens
I don't,
if you break what happens if it breaks a bolt off?
I don't think it ever would. I think it's,
well, you can't. I mean, how do you help it? You know what I mean? Like, how many bolts have you broken? Like, you know what I mean? Like, if it's rusty, if it's whatever, like, how do you
but
know?
I think that they also have, like, at that point, if it's getting to that point, it's going to have a induction. It's going to have something that's going to heat up
Maybe.
Something just
Maybe.
So it never does it.
Maybe.
That's how I would see it. It would just be an induction tool that they have on an arm that will bring it down.
But what if the last jerk off robot cross threaded it?
Very true. Very true. I mean, that one would be kicked. But at the same time, like, there's ways that they could do it. And imagine just, if they cross-threaded a bolt, if they extract it, which they probably know how, they're already going to have a fucking a die that's cut that it can just cut it perfectly and send it.
Probably.
Be seconds, dude.
I think it would be more along the lines of what a lot of manufacturers are starting to do and just replace parts. You know what I mean? Like, if you have an engine failure, you just replace the engine. You don't fix it.
Yeah.
And a robot can do that, maybe. Can just take the engine out. Like, that's all it has to do is take the engine out and put it back in.
I'm surprised.
I don't have to fix anything. I don't have to diag anything. I don't have to do anything. I just have to take the engine out, put the engine in.
I'm actually surprised that it doesn't have, like, AI now working in our cars. Okay, Tesla's a different story. I work for them. They do have certain things that's like, whoa, like, what the fuck? But, like, on other manufacturers, like, we should have, like, maybe more of an advanced AI that can tell us exactly what the fuck it was. You know what I mean? It does give us a really, really good idea. But it doesn't pinpoint it to the point where it knows exactly what that was.
Yeah.
I think eventually it's going to get to that point. It might be easier for us. But at the same time, replacing, I don't think they're, I think that's years off.
Well, you think about, you know, being able to control cars and stuff. We talked about that earlier. Like, I got a new truck. It has Wi-Fi. Technically, anybody can break into my shit and just do whatever. You know what I mean? Like, anything it can do electronically, you can probably...
Electronically, but it couldn't control your truck.
Well,
maybe not
my truck specifically, because the steering isn't electronic. It's manual steering. But if it had electronic steering, why not?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, it's got maps. You know, it's got Google Maps. It knows where the roads are. It knows a lot of things. It has stop sign recognition, for God's sakes.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, it's there. It's close. It's real close. You know, Tesla has self-driving cars. Nissan actually has self-driving cars. It's not out in the public yet, but it's
there.
Yeah, they have the technology.
An Aria. But the thing is, like, as much as we hear that now, how many companies are stepping away from electric cars to go to hydrogen?
Well, that's...
So, it's that's where I think they're going to cut it.
Well, as far as power plants go, but why can't the rest of the car be all electronic? Why can't the steering be electronic? Why can't the, you know what I mean? The engine may not be electronic, but you can.
That's where I'd like to think, like, why switch something that's already working or like, but they are. They're doing it. Like
they want to move forward.
It's gonna happen.
Yeah, that's just that's the technological advancement. That's how they do it.
I think what I would like to see is, so I don't have road rage, just self-driving cars. None of
you
us
do have road rage, just about as anybody
like,
I've ever met.
I'm very, like, the thing is, I'm very, like, I pay attention so much to everyone on the road that I know everything around me that's happening. Like, if I, like, I pay attention way too much. So if someone's on their phone, I get fucking heated. And anyone that drives with me knows it. I'm like, dude, they're on their fucking phone. And we'll look. Yeah, they're on their fucking
Listen,
phone.
We'll be sitting at a red light. And you're like, what the fuck? How long does this red light take?
But I'm saying, like,
like it's fucking their fault.
Yeah, but at least on Audi's end, on that. Okay, let's talk about that. Audi has a AI in there or whatever they have, the chip, that when I pull up to a light, it tells me how many seconds it's going to take to get to green.
Get out here, really?
Swear to God. Yeah, you pull up to a light, it shows you the counter.
So
on
much
how
of time, it must have timed it. It must knows, have seen it and it, timed it.
It knows the traffic lights by the actual program of that the traffic lights are programmed. So when you're coming up to a light, it will tell you 26 seconds when you're coming up. So you know to judge it.
Well, like right now, after Hurricane Ian came through, all the traffic lights were fucked up. The timing
fucked. They're
the
fucked.
Timing system in Cape Coral was physically damaged.
Yeah,
and it was going to cost like $5 million.
And they're still fucked.
Or whatever, because they don't have the money to fix the fucking things. So, well, they do. They just don't want to fix it.
Yeah.
And then they had chip problems and parts on back order, whatever, blah, blah, blah. Long story short, they didn't fix the fucking timing of the light. So it takes you forever to get anywhere now because of the timing is so fucked up. So I get, you know, an Audi wouldn't be able to judge that. I'm wondering if it sees the light from you coming. You know what I mean? Like it can say.
Oh,
okay,
no, it knows it
red.
To like the exact second, dude.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Like it can time it. Like as you're going up to a stoplight that's a mile away, maybe it can
see
it and go.
I think what it's recording is every day. So I think that's what it does. It records every day how long that light takes to get to green. When you're driving past it, or it's just picking it up from a Wi-Fi signal, it knows.
Maybe.
How?
Maybe system.
Just
know,
like how we
crazy.
Have Wi-Fi in our cars. But like, yeah, you're driving. So if you're like gunning it, you're like, oh, I got 3 seconds till it's green. You can fucking gun it and you know when that's turning green.
Then the asshole doesn't stop that's running the light because you're the guy that doesn't stop running the light.
I'm just saying. Oh, I'm just saying, like, I think Audi would be the best choice for me on that part. But like they have those things, like I'm surprised like all of our cars don't have this, but it's just one thing that would be a really good thing. Like people driving, like people that are fucking assholes driving. Not me. I'm not an asshole driving. I just don't like when people don't pay attention. It's I am all about paying attention to the road. No phone in your hand. Yes, at a stop, I'm like, come on, motherfucker, let's go. But I'm just saying, like, I think they could all do that. I think they can do it. I don't know why. And I don't know why none of the other manufacturers do that.
Well, like I have a 24 now. So mine has like stop sign recognition, like street sign recognition.
That a lot.
I don't know how to use it yet because I'm borderline retarded, but I
know wrapped it around a pole.
They didn't tell me it was coming. I don't know. Yeah.
Yep.
You're supposed to recognize it. You move. Like
I know what you mean. Do?
But like it has all that technology to say, okay, that's a stop sign, that's a yield sign, that's a a roundabout sign, whatever is there.
So if it recognizes that, when is the time where it's gonna dumb your car down so you have to obey it? You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, and now my car's got Wi-Fi, so theoretically, anybody that wanted to get into my car,
I hope I can break into your Wi-Fi and send you things that you do not want to see or you want to see. I'm not going to say anything.
As I'm driving down a road, a big black dong pops up on my radio.
I'm
going to
do
minute.
Something. I'm going to do something. It's just,
sending me.
I'm going to figure it out.
Terrible pictures while I'm driving.
Yes, I'm going to figure it out.
I'm driving with my mother and just like, ding, ding, ding.
Oh.
What are all these pictures?
I'm going to do it. But I'm saying, it's just, I think you can go anywhere at this point. Like, I can't wait to see what happens in 5 to 10 years on how advanced it gets. Because if they're already advanced enough where they're doing what they're doing with robots, I can only imagine the intelligence they're going to have as a human, where you can't distinct a voice from a human and a robot. It's going to happen.
Well, even right now, the really interesting part about that robot video that we were talking about with the apple,
yeah,
is that guy would like pause and like he had a very human tone and a very human rhythm when he spoke. Like he put the ums and the ahs and the, you know, pauses in there and like stuttered for a second.
He did it perfectly where a human would do it.
Yeah, exactly.
It's like, and it's almost like if you shut your eyes and you listen, I don't think you could almost understand if it was a human or AI. Because it was so good. Like, I'm like, when I listened to it in person, yeah. I stared at it. I'm like, dude, like, it's, that's getting like,
it had the tiniest hint of robot in it. But yes. The vernacular, the rhythm, everything about it was very human like, as far as, you know.
Did you see, I don't know if you saw it in like the headlines, but did you see the movie The Creator? Like, it's that AI movie that came out. With a child.
I didn't see the movie, but I know what you're talking about.
So I watched it the other day. I actually watched it like 2 days ago. They actually brought those exact robots with the facial expressions. You could not tell in an MLB crowd. They brought it to a baseball game. Right, you couldn't tell the difference if it was a human with a hat on or a robot. You couldn't do it. Like, it's that realistic now.
Wow.
So we know what you're going to have at your house eventually. I'm going to just say that right off the bat.
But so real-like.
But I'm saying, did you ever see that video of them in the baseball crowd?
No, I didn't. I don't. You know what? I might have.
So they look so real.
I didn't
real.
Pay attention it, to it, it, but I think I saw something.
I think they did it for publicity for the movie, The Creator.
That's what it was. Yeah.
And it was, they had them so identical. Skin looked identical to a human, dude. You couldn't tell the difference unless they pointed it out.
And they got those real dolls now, like the sex dolls that are like, they say that they're almost like they're almost indistinguishable. Other than, you know, they're not bitching at you.
You mean the Whackmaster 3000 that you already own? Oh, man. That was hilarious.
I got the 3000 the 3001.
Yeah, it's the 3000 plus. Comes with extra thrusting. But I'm saying,
with three entrances. But, and see, this is why we can't do a podcast.
I know. But I'm saying, like, they're so fucking real like now. Dude, it's unreal, dude. It's all right.
We have to push each other. Wakes you up in the middle of the night.
Yep. Not now.
No, I'm trying to sleep. Leave me alone.
Oh man. Yeah, it's hilarious.
Anyway, I got two on order. They'll be here tomorrow.
Exactly, dude.
I mean, how am I not going to test them out?
I won't see you for a week.
He's been trying to do a podcast for a month and a half now. He hasn't left his house. It's like Quagmire when he comes out of Family Guy and he learns about the internet. Yep. And he comes out of his house and his right arm is just huge.
It's just massive.
He's been at home jerking off for the past month.
That was fucking
Quagmire,
hilarious.
We haven't seen you in a month.
But the fact is, it's everyone knows it's going to get to that point. It's going to.
Yeah.
And not just for like anyone. It's just like, it's everything's going to happen the way you think it would happen. Like,
yeah,
you know what I mean? It's
well,
like,
you know what, man? There's truth in the fiction that, you know what I mean? Like,
the
movies that they make, like, there's a little bit of reality there, you know, that they go off of.
The thing is, like, even though it'd be really cool to see like a robot that you couldn't tell from like me and you, I would just like to see them like iRobot, like the movie. I know that they are a robot, that am I being tricked right now,
right?
Because they're going for the ultimate, like, mirror image of us.
I don't know that that's the answer. I think the answer is,
yeah, I think it's it. We should know if I'm talking. It's like, have you ever seen the movie, like the new Blade Runner? Have you seen it or no?
No.
I watched the movie as soon as we get off this podcast. It's so good, and it's like how they made the movie. That's exactly how I see it in the future. Exactly. Like it's with fucking
it's what's his name? Bane, right?
Ryan Gosling.
Oh.
He's the main
Wasn't
character
Tom
in
Hardy
this.
in one of those? No, that was Mad Max, I think, right?
Mad Max, yeah.
Yeah.
Ryan Gosling, Harrison Ford, and Batista, he's in it. He's one of the AI robots that you can
Right.
never tell. You have to see this movie. It's probably one of my top five favorite movies. Cinematic wise, it's incredible how they did it.
You like Interstellar, so that's questionable.
As anyone that's listening to this right now, that the taste that I have, you like maybe Toy Story 2 or something. You're right up that alley. I'm
What's
more
wrong with
like,
Andy, bro?
Yeah, I'm just saying,
Andy's my boy.
Andy didn't believe the toys were real. So whatever you needed to
Oh, he knew
think
they're real.
about.
His mother didn't.
I'm telling you right now, Blade Runner was at both of them. The original with Harrison Ford and the new one with Ryan Gosling were one of the best movies for AI. You have to see it. Like, if you haven't seen it, you have to watch that movie.
The new Blade Runner. When did it come out? How old is it?
It came out about 4 years ago.
Do you see the new Roadhouse they're making with Jake Gyllenhaal and
I'm telling you right
what's his
now,
name?
the one that came out in the 80s to this one, I think this one's going to be really fucking good.
I think so. I think it's just did it come out? I think it just came out or it's coming out.
It's not out yet. They like I keep seeing clips of Jake Gyllenhaal and doing certain skits, and like the director is actually like they're all having fun on set, and it's like random, dude. They're not setting up a scene. It's like they're going off on the side of the road where cars
Yeah.
are passing,
Yeah,
doing.
yeah, yeah.
So I don't think it's out yet, but something I'm definitely gonna watch. Only because of they have like Jake Gyllenhaal is a really good actor, so it's like
Yeah.
I'll
And
probably
I
it's
think
like who do
Conor McGregor's in it. He's like
he
the other
is.
guy.
Yeah, he's in it.
Yeah. That'll be interesting. I'll watch that.
But other than that, I think off topic, I'm gonna watch Lincoln Lawyer because we talked
Oh,
about
you
this
got
earlier.
to, dude. It's such a good show. Watch it today.
I'm going to. I'm gonna I have
I'm
nothing
gonna
else to
rewatch it
watch.
because season three comes out in August, I think.
Oh, so I'm gonna watch it. I've never seen it, so I've seen the movie with
Season two ends in such a like even season one ends really well. But the ending of season two, you're like, damn.
I saw like when I was in the movies with you earlier before the movie started, I started watching like videos of it. Like I already know just from how that guy acts, I'd probably like the movie
I don't.
or the
I th
show.
he's got to be in something else because I don't
He
know where they just found him, but I don't remember.
looks like he's in something
He
else, but
looks like
he's
somebody
not.
you recognize, but I don't know
He
where he's from.
looks like the character in Game of Thrones called Littlefinger, which is you don't know. I don't think you've watched that, but
Not that
another
far.
it's my best favorite show of all
I
time.
need to start watching that because the House of Dragons, the new House of
I
Dragons.
watched. I think I watched 7 episodes yesterday. It's first
Yeah,
season.
I gotta watch it.
Off the bat, it's so good,
I've
dude.
watched the first season and like got into the second season, but then whatever happened, and I just stopped, kind of got out of it.
I'm telling you right now, it'd be one of your, like it's one of the best seasons with the biggest letdown of the last season. And not in like a bad way. Some people really liked it. I didn't
Like the
because
last
like.
seasons of Game of Thrones, you mean?
Yeah, and it's
Was it
just
like
like
season 5 and 6 you were talking about? Or six, whatever it is?
it's like up there,
Eight,
eight.
seven, or eight? I heard the last couple of seasons were kind of not eh.
Just the last couple episodes sucked. It's like, oh, it could have been so much better, but it was still
Yeah.
good. I liked how they did it, but I think House of the Dragon, I think that show is really good, and the new one coming out is gonna be fucking
The House of
awesome.
the Dragon was really fucking good.
Really good, dude. How they did it, and
Yeah.
it comes out actually pretty soon, actually, the new one.
That one is really good.
So
I
excited
didn't think
about
I would
that.
like that as much as I did actually.
And that's how I thought. Like coming off of it, it's a spin-off, but they're also doing a couple spin-offs of Game of Thrones.
Yeah.
You have to
Snow,
watch
what's his name? White
Jon Snow.
Jon Snow, that's what it is. Yeah, Jon
They're
Snow is.
supposed to be doing a spin-off off of him. So
Yeah,
if that
there's a
happens,
Jon Snow series, I guess, coming.
hopefully. We'll see. But like I haven't really seen much of it,
House of
but
Snow, or I don't know, something like that.
Other than that, I think, like I'm one of those people that I think that AI can help us more than it can hurt us, onto a
Yeah,
point.
I lean that way. I think that
I
AI
think that
is
it'll
it's
make people.
inevitable. I mean, there's nothing you're gonna do about it.
It
It's
is,
coming.
and when you accept it, I think it'll make your life easier when you know what it's
Well, it's
doing.
just like anything else, man. Anything new is like, oh my God, this is gonna be terrible, end of the world, blah blah blah. And some things are terrible, and then some things work out
So
really well.
I get it, but like at the same time, I think that they'll have like in movies they explain it like, oh, they're taking over. I think like, yo, there's a shutoff, but like, you know, the motherboard's controlling that. I think there'll be a it there'll be a like a security breach, like security like 2 times that we can shut it off before they
Yeah.
even gets to that point. You know
Well,
what I mean?
what if they get smart enough to where they can bypass that?
I
Or
don't think they can because of like the ultimate creator, like more like ChatGPT or like one of the guys has a laptop in his backpack at all times. Something happens, he's shutting it down completely. He can shut it down with a single keystroke.
what if he can buy? What if they bypass that and go,
I don't
yeah,
think they
you can
can at
do
that point because of like
that. I don't
you.
know.
I get it. I get it. You could, like, if the computer's smart enough to get that
What if that
point,
guy dies? What if that guy gets hit by a bus and
there's gonna be so many fires, like firewalls that you
yeah.
can or fire, like
You gotta have multiple people because
something's yeah, and something's
you
gonna
know.
happen where it's like shut it down,
And like those people can
like
never be in the same room and all that kind of stuff.
it's kind
There
of
was
like
a
that.
story of like the people who invented Coke, like the two guys that came up with like Coca-Cola. Like
Yeah.
they would never fly together, they would never travel together, they would never be at the same place at the same time because they both
No.
had the ingredients and they were the only ones that knew about it. So
Yeah.
they couldn't fly together, they couldn't do
We
anything
talk about
together.
that. We talk about that good stuff, that cocaine. You
Oh,
never know. You know what I
those
mean?
guys
Like,
flew together all the time, dog. You
all
know
the
what I'm
time. But I'm
saying?
saying, like, you never know, like, what the ingredients are. We don't know to this
I'm trying to
day.
get on
Like,
that flight. You know
oh my.
what I'm saying?
But like, just like that. That's like Tesla did a like Tesla. That happened with Tesla. Everyone died that did the what car was that? Can't think of it off the Roadster. They all
Yeah.
died. Everyone died off of that. They all went on a plane together going to a meeting. They all
Oh
fucking died,
yeah.
dude. It was like
Yeah,
the one thing I
what?
heard when I worked there. It's like it's just there's no one else, like engineer wise, for the Roadster.
Right.
Like the older one, not the newer one. Like the
Right,
newer
right,
one
right.
coming out, that's a different story. But like Tesla is now like buying back all the old ones.
Right.
Like from my experience, it's just there's not enough of them, and people that want them, they're gonna keep them. It's all it is a Lotus body on top of an electric car.
I just don't
That's
think we're ready for the electric car market yet. Like, I don't think it's there yet. There's not
I.
enough. There's not enough charging stations. There's a lot of
The
infrastructure that we need. Like,
infrastructure is there for Tesla. It's not there for any other manufacturer ever. I can
well,
tell you right
they say
now.
that if we were at 20% of what they wanted us to be at, those they want us to be at, that the power grid couldn't maintain it. Anyway, like our power grid would
Unless you
fail.
figure out a solar issue, you know what I mean?
Well,
Solar.
solar, I mean, you know.
That's the thing. Like, how many fucking how. How many solar panels can you have before
Elon
it's
Musk says
sustainable?
that within 100 square miles,
He could.
if you have 100 square miles of land empty,
Yeah.
you can power the United States with solar.
I heard that. Oh, I watched a documentary on that, I believe.
But it's not, I think that's not the bigger problem. The bigger problem is getting it everywhere. Like you have to have plants
I
here,
think
plants
he's.
there, plant, you know what I mean?
Yeah, you have to have it everywhere,
Then you
dude.
got to have stations, you know. But he's talking about being off of like natural gas or any kind of gas, oil altogether, just
Yeah.
being completely self-sustainable with
Yeah.
100 square miles. But what happens if one of them fail in the middle and like they got to go find out which panel failed? You know what I mean?
Well, I think at that point, if you've done that you could you
There
can
it
re
is. You made
I did.
it 48 minutes. That was pretty good.
That was a half yawn. That was a
You
half yawn. I stopped it because I knew I knew you're gonna
did
say
pretty
something.
good, buddy. I'm proud of you.
I'm just saying, I think when we if we got to that point, they would be able to pinpoint it like that, dude.
You would think
Like
so.
they would be able to. I know exactly what panel, what module. I know where to go. I know to
Yeah.
fix it. And
You would
but
hope so.
the only problem we have to have is what if a solar flare comes and knocks out everything?
Yeah.
You're done. You're done. You're done. It's not that we can't control it. It's just it's gonna happen randomly. We're fucked. It's a blackout. So at that point, all those cars are worthless at that point. Like you don't like it's not
Or an
a
EMP or, you know, a terrorist
exactly an
thing or
EMP
something like that. Like,
is set off. Like and they know
what do
what
you
we
do about
have.
that? Like, you
So
can't, and anything electronic, it destroys, so you would have to redo everything.
yeah.
Yeah, which is, I mean, which is possible right now. I mean, they, you know, they have EMPs that can do that right now. Like,
yep. And that's like one of the huge things with like Russia, and they have EMP rockets that are up there.
Yeah.
Just waiting. Just, yeah, you know, you're going to cause a war. We're going to take out all your electronics. That's,
but you know, that, and, that pretty much ensures mutual destruction, just like yeah. nukes or anything else. So,
oh, I'm not against that. It's as like, long it keeps as
they're,
the peace.
As long as they're not fucking, you know, somebody's on their last day and they're like, eh, you know, fuck it. I'm dying tomorrow. So
yep, let's
you know
cause what I mean? Chaos.
Yeah. Like,
you know what I mean?
You know, if Putin wakes up with like cancer tomorrow and has 6 months to live, who knows what the fuck he's capable of?
Yeah.
But that, you know, that goes with anybody.
But I mean, go on. Like, I don't think that would happen only because of like, if you watch the Tucker Carlson documentary, like, I mean, he makes some really strong points. Yeah. It's not like against anything. It's just in the middle. I'm seeing things that are like, okay, that makes sense.
Yeah.
Okay, that makes sense. I but mean, like at the same time, we have to protect our own like he does. But it's like, yes. I think the U.S. takes things a little extreme. Like they try to control things in different countries. I don't think that's like we should be doing that. Let's worry about our own. But,
yeah, I mean, that's an argument to be made for that.
But what happens when AI takes control of both of those?
Well, that's what I'm saying.
Like, it's a 60-40. Let's take them out. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
You don't know what they're thinking.
Like, what are the metrics AI uses to say, okay, I'm going to push a button now?
Yep.
No. Yeah. Is, you know, what's the logic that they use that it's going to use to make these type of decisions?
Yeah.
Like, that's what you have to question and worry about.
Yeah.
If they use some kind of flawed logic or a left-leaning logic or a right-leaning logic, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah, fucked.
Yeah. Who knows? Like,
yeah, it can't be a median. It can be just one way or the other. They're going to decide off of percentages, nothing else. It's just how they're doing it.
Probably. I mean, that's.
Yeah. And the thing is, like, are they going to care about casualties? I don't think so. I don't. I think they're just going to go off
well,
of
you,
what's going to win.
And that's another thing. Like, how do you introduce human emotion? How do you make it sympathetic? How do you make it?
I'm just really hoping that, like,
empathetic.
The AI doesn't go to the woke way. And it's just absolutely horrible for every one of us.
Well,
you know
I
what
mean,
I mean,
that's, you know, that's another thing. Like,
it's just, yeah. It's,
in order for AI to take over, you have to find a way to make it empathetic. You have to find a way for it to quantify what it means to be empathetic, or, you know,
which I don't think they can do. I don't like.
There probably is a way to. There has to be like a specific measurement for it, though. And I
maybe
don't know
they're
how
taking
you
percentages
that.
Off the people. Like,
maybe
not themselves in general.
Right.
So that's maybe where they can get their empathy from. It's like they see posts online.
Can it learn it? You know what I mean? Like, maybe it learns it. Maybe it sees, like, you know.
Yeah.
But then, you know, again, you learn empathy from emotion. So if you don't have emotion, you don't have fear, you don't have sadness, you don't have, you know, joy. Can you program joy into something? I don't know if you can.
I don't think so.
You can, and you know, I guess if you find a way to measure it and quantify it to say, okay, well, this is what joy equals. And I'll set your joy level at 4. You know what I mean, or whatever. Like, you know,
yeah, it's just like Interstellar. Oh, you're when he's like, oh, what did he say? When he's talking to the robot, he set his jokingly down like 5%.
Yeah,
he's
yeah,
like,
yeah.
Okay. Like,
yep.
SARS, I think it was called, or something.
Right.
But it's the same thing. It's like you can set it. So who's
same principle.
It? Yeah, it's the same thing, dude.
You know, what do you set it at, and how do you set it? How do you quantify it?
Yep.
Crazy. I say we just let it all burn. I'm just gonna sit back and.
Yep. Just watch what happens.
Yeah.
But I mean, yeah, it's gonna be fucking nuts, dude. But I say we call it here for this episode. It's actually a great episode on AI. It's one of my favorite things to dive into, like, because it's so the unknown, but like it's happening every day and it's just getting smarter and smarter.
Yeah.
100%. So it's not that people have to keep an eye out for it, but like at least have the idea of, you know, what could happen if it went beyond our, like, how we think, like, what happens at that point? So,
well, you know, when it comes to people like you and I that just, like, you're way more computer savvy than I am, but you're far beneath some of these guys. You know what I mean? Like,
Oh yeah, dude.
I'm autistic when it comes to, you know, some of these things.
But at least you have the idea that it's gonna happen and you can think about it. It's like, okay. So like imagine people listening right now, they never even thought about AI taking over.
Right.
It's definitely a possibility, knowing if you just go on the internet and search it, that they are making them smarter than us and they can make irrational decisions, like just like us. So it's like it's cool to think about. Like, I'm not saying anything against it, I'm not saying anything for it. I'm in the middle. I want to see where it goes. I think it can help us.
Yeah, like, what do you do about history? Right? Like, what do you do about, you know what I mean? Like, so, the subject of slavery or the subject of monuments or stuff like that. Like, the computer has no empathy or care.
Next time
about,
I go to the Washington, the Lincoln Memorial, half of it's a robot.
You know what I mean?
Like,
yeah, you know what I mean? Like,
you don't know what they're going to change, dude.
There's so many different subjects that come up, like, in our culture that, you know, politically and stuff like that, that you have to look at and be like, you know, people are tearing down monuments and shit back, you know, a couple years ago or whatever. Yep. Like, how does AI decide what monument is cool and what one's not? You know what I mean? Like, how
exactly
you take a poll?
How do they know?
Like, and they don't have an idea of history to be able to go, okay, well, this is important because of whatever, you know, this man did this.
Maybe they cleared it. Like, it's, no one knows. Like,
yeah,
we don't know in like 100 years, dude. Yeah. Like, what it can be.
And the problem with AI is that the faster it develops, the faster it develops. You know what I mean? Like, it gets, it's exponentially faster.
Yeah.
You know, every year it grows by 2 years. You know what I mean? Every 2 years, it probably grows by 4 years. That's just exponentially growing.
It's so much faster than we can comprehend. It's,
at what point does it start writing its own AI?
Yeah, you know off of that, like, AI. And it's another robot off of a robot.
Yeah.
So, fucking nuts.
You know, and then you look about, like, people talk about, like, the simulation theory and stuff like that. And which is a whole nother conversation. But
which I would love to get into in our next podcast. Yeah, that'd be actually be fun. Definitely think so. But
maybe we're the AI, bro. Maybe we are controlled by alien somewhere, and they're just having a good time watching us burn. You know what I mean?
I wouldn't be surprised.
Like, think about it; it'd be crazy.
If you think about it, that's stupid. But no, if you think about it, it's like we could be in a simulation; no one would ever know.
Yeah.
Like, it's like watching The Sims, or you're playing The Sims. You're controlling a character. What if that person is you in a game, and you never even knew it? It's like you're controlling someone from a different point. And so imagine if you turned on your computer, that's the big bang every time you turn on your computer.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It could be that situation. It's like, it's a weird way to look at it, but like, that's starting a process that turns on everything at once.
Yep.
So it's cool to think about. Like, I really enjoy thinking about those things, not thinking they're unrealistic, but it's just thinking like that could have happened.
Like, yeah. I like to think about it and, like, you know, think about, okay, well, if that's the case, like, what matters, what doesn't matter, what, you know, because, like, essentially, it's like, if you're a simulation, everything that you do is still the same, right? Like, you're still got to go to work. Yep. You still got to do all these things. So you don't know the difference one way or the other. So it really makes no difference to you.
Yeah.
Whether you're alive and real or whether you're a simulation.
Yeah, and doing the same thing.
You still got to pay rent, you still got to pay mortgage, you still got to pay car payments, blah, 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 right?
So it's the more you play the game. It's
how far do you get in the game, you know?
We'll have to get into simulation because I actually really want to talk about that
one. Like the people that disappear in Alaska, maybe they just got out of the game.
I'm sorry, but what if they just got rebooted? You never know.
What if they just got out of the game? All these people disappear, you know what I mean?
It could happen that way, eventually.
Maybe. I don't know. I'm not a smart guy, bro. I just talk about this shit.
yeah, me too. It's fun to talk about. And
speaking of aliens in Alaska, we're looking for guests and stuff. So if you're looking to, if you got any kind of alien encounter or stories that you want to talk about,
or spent a week in Alaska or a weekend in Alaska that you had a weird experience, reach out to us on our Facebook or email, thenerdinformers@gmail.com, or check us out.
Yeah, email us. We're looking for guests for.
Yeah, it's always fun to talk about. But other than our
paranormal stuff, if you've ever been haunted.
Oh yeah,
I'm down to talk about it.
So I think our next episode we can do another one in a couple days. want to get another. I want to do simulation theory. That'd be simulation fun to talk would be cool. About.
I've done a lot. Yeah, I've done a lot of reading about that. That's super, super like interesting to me.
Yeah, I would actually really, really enjoy that one.
I listen to Neil deGrasse Tyson talk about it a lot.
That's one of my favorites to listen to, man.
Yeah, and the way he talks about it, you're like, you know.
He's not wrong. He's not right. Like, so it's like in between.
Know. All right, that's a wrap, guys.
Yeah, everyone listening on the Nerd Informer, thank you guys for stopping by. We're going to be, the new season, we're going to be doing hopefully 2 a week. That's our goal. So check us out. Oh, we'll talk about aliens. We'll talk about simulation theory. We'll talk about anything that you guys want to talk about, history. You guys have a great day.
Later.
Later, guys.